Akin, our follower, who is my Yoruba cousin, and all members of the NiDO for the invitation. I also want to thank Alhaji Abdullahi Dauda, who is a Kanuri man from Bornu State, Nigeria, for receiving me at the airport. I congratulate you all for the successful organization of the 2013 AGM and World Conference. Yorubas claim to be our cousins, but since the Boko Haram is here, we have not seen them again. I am therefore standing before you as the representative of His Excellency Governor Kashim Shettima of Bornu State of Nigeria, who is unable to be personally here because of the acute security situation in Bornu State. He therefore requested me to come all the way from Bornu to convey his profound apologies and to stand in for him. As introduced, I am the secretary to the state government of Bornu State since the year 2006, and therefore privileged to know much about the insurgency in Bornu State. As a former ambassador of the Federal Republic, political, not Kaya, and current member of the Presidential Committee on Dialogue and Peaceful Resolution of Insecurity Challenges in the North, I will endeavor to provide illumination into the genesis of the insecurity, especially in Bornu State, to which I will generally confine myself. My very distinguished fellow Nigerians, invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, let me start by repeating what our Governor Kashim Shettima said sometime in April 2012 when he presented a paper at a security summit in Abuja by bluntly saying that none of us here should be in the illusion that he or she is doing a favor to the organizers of this great event by being here as an invited guest. Let the organizers also not feel that they have done any of us favor by inviting us to this great event, because by charting the course of peace as organizers of a conference like this, you are also working for yourselves, and so are we for coming. Peace is a gift we offer to one another. So if, for example, anyone thinks he or she is safe in the United States, so he or she does not care what happens back home, then we should ask ourselves, why is America fighting the Taliban in Afghanistan? Why has America gone to Pakistan to kill Osama bin Laden? We should remember that the US is fighting abroad because insurgency is mobile. If you do not tame homegrown insurgency in Nigeria as you are trying to do by this event, the insurgents will export their evil to where you are today. They will pretend and come in as good Nigerians and then strike. If your family and friends are based in the southern part of Nigeria, far away from the troubled north, so you do not care, then remember that suicide attacks were hitherto heard or known with trouble in the Middle East. But in 2012, we recorded an alien suicide attack in Nigeria and in Abuja, our federal capital. That is the mobility of terrorism. If insurgents are allowed to hold sway in the northern part of Nigeria, they will move to the south because their goal is to capture a country, then a continent, and then the world. Everyone must think like them. This is their goal. As Nigerians, though based in the United States, you might have relations, friends, or even investments back in Nigeria, and where there is no peace in Nigeria, you are directly or indirectly affected. If you have no relations, friends, or investments in Nigeria, which should be unfortunate, at least. At least your integrity is affected by the opinions your American friends, colleagues at work, and business associates hold about Nigeria. They will see you as someone who hails from a Nigeria where some group of people slaughter their fellow citizens for the mere matter of religious perception. These opinions that the people you deal with here might have about Nigeria perhaps influences what they think or even make of you as someone who's Nigerian origin. No matter your level of citizenship in the United States today, you will still be called a Nigerian American. This is why the conference should be as important to you as it is to us that you have invited. We are gathered here as equal stakeholders in the Nigerian project as it concerns the country's stability and its position in the global arena, which is why the event has as its theme, I quote, "Towards a New Era Nigeria, Building Sustainable Partnership for National Development and Homeland Security," unquote. I must, as a matter of obligation, commend the organizers of this occasion for the first-rate initiative and firm coordination, which must be born out of love for their fatherland or motherland, Nigeria. Borno State is one of the 36 of Nigeria. 36 states of Nigeria, Borno is one. It is located at the far northeastern corner of Nigeria, sharing border with three international countries of Chad, Niger, and Cameroon Republics. Borno is the largest state after Niger State in Nigeria in terms of geographical spread. Borno has a long history of Islam, such that all those seeking for Islamic knowledge moved en masse to Borno, thereby creating a concentration of Al-Majri, which easily became a reservoir for recruitment into the Boko Haram Islamic movement. The heavy concentration of Al-Majris was complemented by unemployed youth and other disillusioned Western educated indigents, culminating into a mass of angry, unemployed, and hungry youth who readily joined the uprising of 2009 in Maiduguri. Ladies and gentlemen, the challenge of insecurity of the scale we have been confronted with since 2009 in Borno is a huge distraction to governments. The unfortunate insurgency spearheaded by the Jamaatul Ahli Sunnah Lidawati Wal Jihad, alias Boko Haram, has left in its wake a heavy toll of death and destruction. Hundreds of human lives have been lost, while hundreds of millions of naira worth of property have been destroyed, not to mention the unquantifiable loss occasioned by the crippling of businesses and other economic activities. Our alien experience in the last 3 years has emphatically brought home to us the wisdom of the axiom that peace is a necessary precondition for development. Borno is currently under a state of emergency, along with Adamawa and Yobe states. Where there is a state of emergency, most aspects of